Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Aletic. In this video I will show you how you can extract text from books with a single camera and Python. You probably have a lot of books at home, but there is no way to get information out of them quickly. No search function ordinary books, nor the ability to read it on the go. Therefore, I will show you how you can transfer the previously bought content into another medium. But how to get all the text? There's a simple way if you have a scanner at home, but they are expensive. Therefore, we will create a script in Python that extracts text from images. The only thing for us to do is to take pictures with our smartphone, run the script, and you will get the text and PDF. To start off, let's take a look at the main function of our code. This function is the entry point of our program, where all the magic happens. First, we define a variable called directory and set it to the directory paths, where our image files are stored. Next, we call a function called getPages to retrieve the file paths of all the image files in the specified directory. The function called getImages loads the images. Now comes the exciting part. We call a function called getTextFromImages to extract text from images. We specify the language parameter as ENG for English. Finally, we have two more functions. The saveText function saves the extracted text as a text file, and the savePDF function saves the images as a PDF file. So let us dive into these functions. The getPages function takes two parameters: dir, which represents the directory path, and FileType, which is an optional parameter set to JPEG by default. Inside the function, we create an empty list called pages. We then loop through the files in the directory using os.list directory. For each file, we check if its extension matches the specified file type. If it does, we add the file path to the pages list. Finally, we sort the pages list and return it. If you like, you can use a list comprehension instead. Now let's take a closer look at the getImages function. Inside the function, we create an empty list called images. We then loop through the pages list. For each file path, we use a cv2imread function from the OpenCV library to read the image. We then convert the image from the default BGR color space to RGB using cv2.convertColor. Finally, we append the RGB image array to the images list. Once again, you can use a list comprehension instead. Now we get to the important part. Inside the function, we initialize an empty dictionary called data with a key called pages. We then iterate through each image using the TQDM library to show a progress bar. Using the PyTesseract library, we convert each image to text using the specified language and configuration. The extracted text is then appended to the pages list and the data dictionary. Finally, the function returns the data. Once again, if you like, you can use a list comprehension. The last thing for us to do is to export the text. We can choose between TXT or JSON, depending on whether we want it to be text or a dictionary. Finally, I would suggest to create a function to save the images as PDF. Therefore, we will use the image to PDF library and its convert function. Now I will show you how you can run this script. Go to this GitHub page, the link is in the description. Let's copy the URL and paste it into the terminal. Now we'll go through each step written here. First, change directory. Next, create an environment variable. Do not forget to activate the environment. We will upgrade the package manager pip and install all the requirements. Let's open the folder we just downloaded. In here, we create a folder called pages. Either use the UI or type mkeydirectory in the terminal. Now we have the pages folder. Let's go into this folder and copy all the pages to this directory. As you can see, the pages are now in this folder. Now we will run the script. Just enter python3convert.py or copy that line of code from GitHub. And don't forget to specify the file type and hit enter. After just a few seconds, you will have all the data. First, the PDF file containing all the images, and of course the extracted text. You can see everything works fine, but be aware that if you have images on your page, it might result in non-ideal text extraction. The text from the book cover was not extracted entirely correct, but the other pages worked great. So that's for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, just give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel.